Hello friends, we are discussing about how to check the type of interaction. Before going to detail, we discuss how matter interact with the particle exchange. These are the three different types for the particle interaction. First one is the electromagnetic interaction. It means that it is a photonic interaction or photonic exchange. Then second one is strong exchange interaction. It means that it is the gluon exchange or self interaction. And third one is the weak interaction. Here W plus minus or Z exchange interaction. These three represented by the Feynman diagram. These are the Feynman diagrams. In the previous diagram, elementary particle interact by exerting force on each other. They are exerting three type of force. One is electromagnetic, weak and strong force. The mechanism core and lepton exert force by exchanging mediator particle like photon, W boson, Z bosons and gluons. These force have three types. One is electromagnetic, weak and strong force. Here for that we use CPT theorem. All interaction are invariant under the combined operation of CPT. Here CPT means charge, parity and time. If CP equals to 1, then T equals to 1. It means that the given reaction is conserved under charge conjugation, parity transformation and time reversal. Checking the condition of charge conjugation. If given particle reaction is acted by, that is charge conjugation, that is if reaction with interchange of particle and antiparticle is allowed, that is invariant, then charge parity is conserved. Here one thing is note that all strong and electromagnetic interaction conserve parity. That means nucleon, hyperons and lepton have even parity, means plus 1. Mesons, pi mesons, kaons and neta 0 have odd parity, means minus 1. Fermions, s equals to half, means the spin is half, and their antiparticle have opposite parity. Boson and their antiparticle have the same parity. It means that suppose we have a nucleon particle, then the parity is even. Hyperon, then the parity is even. Lepton, the parity is even. In another case, isospin, third component of isospin and Trenet's number, these three are conserved. It means that the given reaction is strong reaction, or in that reaction there is a strong interaction. If isospin is not conserved, but third component of isospin is conserved and Stannis quantum number is conserved, then the given reaction have the electromagnetic interaction. If isospin and third component of isospin and Stannis quantum number, these three are not conserved, it means that the given reaction is weak reaction or weak interaction reaction. Here conserve mean del I equals to 0, del I3 equals to 0 or del S equals to 0. It means that the resultant isospin is 0 or third component of isospin is 0 or resultant Stannis quantum is 0, because when we applying in both sides, means LHS and RHS, if they are equally will have the same answer, or they are equally will be cancelled to each other, then it have the zero value, then the given reaction is conserved. If I3 and del S doesn't have the zero value, means it more than zero, it means that the reaction is not conserved. We study how to find out the strong interaction. This question determine whether the following reaction are allowed or forbidden through strong interaction. The two reaction are given, P plus P give rise to K plus plus sigma plus. In the first reaction, the charge Q is conserved because for proton the charge is 1, the another proton charge is 1, K plus have charge is 1, and sigma plus have the charge is plus 1. These have the zero value when we are exchanging, then means in both side 2, in another side also 2 will get cancelled, it means that it is 0. Then the charge is conserved because in both side the same value is obtained. Then we have to find the baryon number. Here proton is the baryon, then but here antiproton is not present, but proton is present, so we represent proton for the baryon number is plus 1, then another proton have a plus 1, but kaons or K plus is not a baryon, then we represent it is 0, and sigma is also the baryon, so we represent by plus 1, then the baryon number is not conserved. Here the proton is not a strange particle or strangeness particle, it doesn't have the strangeness quantum number, then it have the zero value, 0 plus 0. In another side, kaons is a strange particle or strangeness particle, it have plus 1 value, and sigma plus have a minus value. Then this reaction is also conserved because in both sides we have the same value, means 0, 0. Then we have to find the third component of isospin, I3. The I3 have, for proton is half, and another proton is half, the K plus have also the half value, but the sigma plus have plus 1. Then the reaction is not conserved, hence this reaction is not possible. Here how to find the I3, we have already learned in the previous topic. So I3, for the finding of I3 we already learned, because I3 equals to Q minus B plus S divided by 2, then from that we can calculate the I3 value or third component of isospin. Hence the given reaction is not possible or not conserved. In the second example we have P plus P, then in another side P plus P plus P plus P bar. So here P bar is nothing but the antiproton. Here charge is conserved because one proton have the plus 1 plus 1, then in another side plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 and minus 1, because anti particle have the minus 1 charge, then plus 1 and 1 minus is cancelled, then the same answer is observed in both sides, hence charge is conserved. So baryon number, proton have one baryon number, then is also baryon number is also conserved. Here strangeness quantum number, because proton doesn't have the strangeness quantum number, or this proton is not a strange particle, so the value of strangeness quantum number is 0, then the strangeness quantum number is also conserved. Then we have to find the third component of isospin. We know that the third component of isospin for proton is half, then half plus half, in another side half plus half plus half and minus half, because proton have the antiparticle of that proton, so we represent by minus half. Then here 1 plus half and minus half will get cancelled, then the given reaction is conserved. Hence the given reaction is possible through strong interaction. Thank you for watching my video. If you like to subscribe my channel.